Okay, so I'm a barista, like, actually. So I was like, I should work on my barista skills, right? Because, like, I want to be better. Anyways, I bought an espresso machine. I thought I would show it with you guys. We're going to make espresso together. Anyways, let's start.
Oh,
this is the Sincreative. They didn't actually, like, name it something fancy like Breville does, so where it's, like, Barista Express, right? It's just, like, a whole bunch of numbers. So all I know is that it has a grinder built into it. That's all I really know. I know it's a Sincreative, and I know it's got the grinder built in. Okay, so with that said, how is it? Okay, so I bought this, like, pre-used, like, in-box. So the only problem I've had is the grinder didn't work right, but I just, like, pulled it out, like, give it a quick brush, and it was great. It grinds really good. It pulls good espresso for, like, a $300 machine. I saw people say that it's not that good, but I've used other machines. So, like, the place that I work, we have a, I don't know if this is actually, like, a big name, but we have an, all I know is that it's an Oscar too. I'll put a picture of it. Okay. I know it's an Oscar, and it's a La Simonelli, I think.
Nuovo Simonelli.
Anyways, it's really similar to this. The only problems that I have with this is that it's not dual boiler, so it can either make espresso or steam milk at one time. Okay, I am gonna add real fast. It's not bad that it's a single boiler. Like, it's not bad. It's great for what I use it for, but if you want something that's gonna make espresso, like, real fast, you might wanna look into something else. So, with that said, it's beautiful. Let's make some coffee. So, I wanna make coffee, because of course, this is what you do with this. Speaking of this, she's going over here now. Okay, so as I was trying to say, it's to the point where I want iced coffee, but a fall flavor. So, like, the leaves are falling, but it's hot. So I'm gonna go grab my hazelnut. I'm back. Pour filter. You just stick it in here. Oh, oh. And just push it in, and then it grinds for you. So this takes a little bit. All right, that looks about good. You just want it just barely over, you tap it. Come on. Yeah, you want it level then. And this is what I love about this. This is perfect. It has this little stop so that you don't ruin your counter. And then you just push down, please. Please. There. I haven't had this machine for very long, so. I did buy a milk pitcher, but I do not actually have the shot glasses, so don't come for me. All right. Double. Pre-infusion. Okay, so I'm not gonna throw it out, but I did not tamp it hard enough because there's this big dial that I hope you saw move, and it did not quite, it got up into the espresso zone, but it did not do it as fast as I had hoped. So this isn't, it's not gonna be a bad espresso shot, but it is. It's gonna be a little bit more bitter than I would have liked. So, of course, dump it in. Look at it. Okay, and then I'll add in the other stuff, and then we'll try it. Okay, it's milk time, but this time we have to be aesthetic, so hold on. sucks to suck. Okay, so now we're in the dining room and we're gonna try it. It needs more flavoring. So like I said, I didn't tamp it hard enough, which means it's a little bit bitter. And I don't really like coffee that much. I know that sounds sacrilegious, but I don't. So we're gonna add a little bit more flavoring to this. All right, it's perfect. And so, highly recommend this. Not sponsored, but highly recommend it. So, I was calculated the costs, and I bought this with one of my paychecks. And then if beans cost like $10 a pound, and then milk is kind of cheap. These you only have to buy like once every forever. It's a lot cheaper. I highly recommend this machine.